Hi guys, today I'm going to be making something that's actually really close to my heart. It's something that I grew up with and have enjoyed throughout my young years and well into my adult years, and have introduced my children to, and that's Ghibli. Today I'm going to be making a Spirited Away music box. I'm going to start by adding my borders first, just so I know what space I have to work with, and just to get the boring bit out of the way. So my wonderful other half bought me this extruder. I didn't actually need to use the extruder, but I really wanted to use it, and I have to say it was really satisfying to play with. Here I'm using a different method to what I would normally use when I'm creating a relief. I'm using the glass from an old frame that I've put masking tape around the edges just so I don't cut myself on. I'm going to lay that down flat on top of my sketches so that I can make sure that I keep my proportions right. So I'm using the same method to create Haku as I did to create Sen, just laying the glass sheet down, using my sketch, just to make sure all that my proportions are correct, and I'm using loads and loads of reference material online. Thank you. while I was making Haku's horns, I just popped in a little bit of 10 gauge wire just so that I could stabilise the structure, and when it baked it has less chance of breaking, just to have that little bit of armature in there. Okay, this is the bit where I need to unreservedly apologise to you all. I completely forgot to press the record button whilst I was making the bottom half of Haku. I used the same process with the glass to make his bottom half and then just made quite a large snake of clay to create his tail. I am so, so sorry. I ran into some heavy cracking issues after my first bake. I did manage to repair it using Milliput, but what they say is like prevention is better than cure, so next time I know to put some holes down so that air can escape. I use my Miller putt the same way that you would use any type of wall filler. With the spare Miller putt that I had left over, I made lots and lots of little eyeballs, which will be great. If you're anything like me, you will need them. So make lots and lots of eyeballs and teeth. Every Ghibli fan knows that you can't have a Ghibli piece without a few soot sprites. You know, 1, 2, 3, 30. These guys took me ages to make. Here I'm getting my trusty UV resin out. I do apologise for the light disturbances. My beautiful little 5-year-old was helping me pick out the colours to make the 60 million crystals that I didn't need. Here I'm attaching the music box mechanism. It plays the theme tune from Spirited Away. It is so adorable, I really do love it. If you want to buy one for yourself, I will leave a link in the description. Now it's time to paint. I am using my Arteza. If anybody knows how to pronounce the name of these paints, could you please let me know in the comments below, because I am really struggling with the name. But yeah, I'm using them today. I hope you enjoy. To create the galaxy in the background, I am using an old piece of makeup sponge. It's a technique that I learned when I was learning how to paint my nails. It seems to translate really well over to painting galaxies, so I decided to use it on a big project too. I know that when creating a star scene, it is quicker to stick a toothbrush into some paint and flick it over your piece, but I prefer to have a little bit more controlled method and place my stars where I want them. It does take a lot longer, but I don't know, I just feel better doing it myself. Here I'm creating a dark blue wash just to sink into all the nooks and crannies into my sculpture, and then I will dry brush white back over the top just so there's a little bit more dimension in the sculpture. So I wanted my music box to sort of tell the story of Spirited Away the best I could. So I decided to put, you know, the entrance into the spirit world on the front of the box, the bridge on the sides, the exit on the back, and on the inside, Yubaba's bathhouse. I'm hoping that it sort of tells the whole story. I think it's just a nice little charming way to tell the tale. Thank you. I painted these pretty blue sky scenes on both sides of the box, just to sort of represent the bridge that no faces stood on for the majority of the beginning of the film. I did a little bit of research into other characters that walked across the bridge at the beginning. So I found some weird and wonderful creatures, and I hope you enjoy watching me paint them. Thank you. I created the bathhouse balcony using toothpicks. I cut them down using wire snips, and then I gorilla glued them to the music box holder. Of course, I glued myself to the box holder as well, because why wouldn't I? And that's it, guys. My Spirited Away music box is complete. I hope you enjoyed watching as much as I enjoyed making. I know it was a bit of a long one today, so if you made it this far, you are a legend. If you'd like to see more, then maybe check out one of my playlists, or you can come in and visit me at Facebook or Instagram.